Good morning to all of you. In the today's lecture, we'll discuss the drug acting on the gastrointestinal system. In our today's lecture, we discuss the following point. First one is the general information about the gastrointestinal tract. Then what is meant by peptic ulcer and which drug are used to treat the peptic ulcer. Then third one is the emetics, anti-emetics and the mechanism of vomiting. Then diarrhea in that means microbial contamination. Diarrhea occurred due to microbial contamination, and diarrhea occurred due to other reason like food poisoning and all. And what kind of drug are used to treat the both diarrhea, that we'll see. And last one is the constipation. Apart from that, we'll also see the inflammatory bowel disease. So first we'll see the general information about the gastrointestinal tract. The first is that the basic difference in the disorder and disease. Disorder means altered functioning of the body system, and a disease caused by harmful microorganism or pathogenic organism. The important part of GIT includes stomach, small intestine, large intestine. The first one is the stomach. Stomach involved in the production of acid, HCl. HCl having two functions. First one is the helpful for the digestion of food. Through that it break down the complex molecule to complex molecule or large food substances into a simpler. The result is that the particle size will decrease. And the second one is the to kill the microorganism. This is the indirect immune function of hydrochloric acid. The second part of gastrointestinal tract is small intestine. It is the site of absorption. Absorption is nothing but the entry into systemic circulation. Decrease in particle size increase the absorption of food. Small intestine is the main site for absorption because of following reason. First one, the digested compound are rich in the small intestine. The second one, small intestine has villi and microvilli. They provide large surface area for the absorption. And third one is that the small intestine has a weak acidic and weak basic pH. And most of the compounds or most of the drug molecules are absorbed in the weak basic and weak acidic pH only. Okay, and if any compound has to go absorption, it has following three properties. First one is small particle size. It should possess a small particle size. It should be in the unionized form, and it has a lipophilicity. The third part of the gastrointestinal tract is large intestine. It is the site of elimination. Elimination takes place through stool and fecal matter. If any compound is not digested and not absorbed, the route of elimination is vomiting. And if the compound is partially digested or incompletely digested but not absorbed, the route of elimination is feces or fecal matter. These are the different disorder that we'll study in today's lecture. First one is the peptic ulcer. Peptic ulcer is nothing but the increase in production of acid, and the drug which are used to treat the peptic ulcer are known as anti-ulcer drug. Second disorder is a chlorohydria, which is nothing but the decrease in the production of acid, and the drug used to treat a chlorohydria are known as drug for a chlorohydria. Third one is constipation. It is decrease in the passage of stool, and the drug which are used to treat the constipation are known as laxatives. Fourth one is the diarrhea. Increase in passage of stool and the drug which used to treat the diarrhea are known as antidiarrheal agents. And last one is the vomiting, related to different part of GIT, and the drug which are used to treat the vomiting are known as emetics and anti-emetics. Okay. The first two disorder, that is mean by peptic ulcer and a chlorohydria, is related to stomach. And next to that, constipation and diarrhea are related to small intestine and large intestine. And vomiting is related to different part of GIT. So we'll move towards our first disorder, that is anti-ulcer drug or peptic ulcer. Okay. The drug which used to treat the peptic ulcer are known as anti-ulcer drugs. Peptic ulcer is characterized by increase in the production of acid, and which is usually takes place in a part of GIT which are highly exposed to acid. Okay. Stomach and duodenum are the most frequently exposed part. So peptic ulcer takes place either in stomach or duodenum. Based on the location, peptic ulcer are of two types. First one is gastric ulcer. ulcers are in stomach and duodenal ulcer. Ulcers in duodenum. Okay, the basic thing that for the development of a peptic ulcer, the two factors are responsible. First one is the aggressive factor and second one is the defensive factors. Okay, aggressive factors are nothing but the factor which increase the production of acid, and defensive factors are the factors which decrease the production of acid. The first condition is that when these both factors are in the balanced state, that time there is no development of ulcer. But if is there any imbalance between aggressive factor and defensive factor, that is increase in the production of aggressive factor and decrease in the production of defensive factor, in that case ulcers are developed. The aggressive factor includes acetylcholine, histamine, gastrin, H. pylori, and defensive factor includes prostaglandin, carbonate and mucus. So basic reason for the development of peptic ulcer or ulcer is the imbalance between aggressive factor and defensive factor. What kind of imbalance? Increase in the production of aggressive factor and decrease in the production of defensive factor. Okay, so here is the general mechanism for the acid production in GIT. So let us consider this square. This square as a gastric parietal cell. As we know that HCl is secreted from the gastric parietal cell, which is also known as oxyntic cell because of the staining. Means these cells are stained with the auxin dye, so they are also known as oxyntic cells. Okay, so let us consider this square as a gastric parietal cell, and these are the different receptor which are present on the gastric parietal cell. Basically there are three types of receptor which are present on the gastric parietal cell. The first one is M1 receptor, muscarinic receptor. The second one is the cholecystokinin receptor, and the third one is the histamine receptor, especially H2 receptors. Okay, and the cholecystokinin receptor is stimulated by two different stimulants. So that's why I took it two times. Okay, so these are the main stimulators for these receptors. For muscarinic receptor, acetylcholine is stimulator. For cholecystokinin receptor, gastrin is a stimulator. And for histamine receptor, histamine is stimulator. And for cholecystokinin, H. pylori is the second stimulator. Okay, so normally these stimulator bind to their respective receptors and they stimulate that receptor. After stimulation of the receptor start to release its secondary messenger, that is nothing but the IP3 DAG. Okay, and when this secondary messenger get released, at that time this secondary messenger act on H+K+AT base. Okay, so that result in the production or secretion of the HCl. This is the normal mechanism. But in ulcer state, the stimulators bind in excessive quantities, or they stimulate the receptor in an excessive manner. So that due to that, these receptor release excessive secondary messengers, and because of that, the final result is there is an excessive production of HCl, and because of that only the ulcers are developed. So this is the mechanism for the acid production. And if we want to counter that mechanism, or if we want to stop the acid production, then we have to use anticholinergic, gastrin antagonist, and histamine antagonist, and H. pylori antagonist. Okay, so then and then only we can stop the excessive production of HCl. Based on this mechanism, the peptic ulcer drugs are classified into mainly four different classes. First one is the drug which reduce the gastric acid secretion, which involves six kind of drugs. Second main class is the neutralization of gastric acid, and third is the ulcer protective drug, and fourth one is a ulcer healing drug. Okay, so the drug which reduce the gastric acid secretion involves antihistaminics, which is nothing but the H2 blocker, then proton pump inhibitor, which is nothing but the H+K+ATPase inhibitor. Proton pump is the main source which secrete the HCl, or due to the stimulation of that proton pump, the HCl is secreted in our body. Okay, Then third is the anticholinergic drug, which is nothing but the selective MN blocker or muscarinic receptor blocker. Then gastrin antagonist. Fifth one is the prostaglandin analogs, and sixth one is the anti-H. pylori drugs. Okay. So now we'll see each class detail. Okay. The first is the antihistaminics, which is also known as H2 blockers. Histamine having three receptor. First H1, H2, H3. All antihistaminics competitively inhibit H2 receptor in parietal cell. All histamines are more effective for reducing basal nocturnal acid secretion, which is stimulated by histamine. Okay, then the acid secretion stimulated by gastrin and HCl. So the drug involves in including this category are cimetidine, ranitidine, famotidine, roxatidine, loxatidine, nisatidine. Ranitidine contain furan ring, famotidine contain thiazole ring. Nizatidine possess anticholinergic activity along with its antihistaminic activity. Because of that its anticholinergic activity, it causes bradycardia and it enhances the gastric emptying. And nizatidine is the only drug which has a 100% bioavailability among antihistamines. Okay. Loxatidine is a non-competitive blocker of H2 receptor. Famotidine is a most potent H2 blocker and bind the both competitively as well as non-competitively. Cimetidine, first drug came in the market, but has an anti-androgenic action and least potent drug. All drugs require reduction in dose in case of renal failure patient. Okay. The second class of peptic ulcer drug is the second class of drug which help in the reduction of gastric acid is proton pump inhibitor, which is nothing but the H+K+ ATPase inhibitor. These are highly effective drug because they inhibit the final step in acid secretion. And the drugs comes under these categories are omeprazole, lansoprazole, pantoprazole, ribeprazole, esomeprazole. Lansoprazole is most potent and safe in pregnancy and increase the metabolism of theophylline. These all drugs are prodrugs. Okay, the active moiety of this drug is sulfanamide, and these all drugs act by binding irreversibly and they inhibit the ATPase H+K+ ATPase in gastric parietal cell. Okay, pantoprazole, esomeprazole, and lansoprazole can be given IV. Drug of choice for gastroesophageal reflux disease and Sjögren's Ehlers-Danlos syndrome. The long-term use of PPI is associated with the decrease in the release of intrinsic factor from parietal cells, which is essential for the absorption of vitamin B12 that result in anemia, which is known as the pernicious anemia. Okay. The third class is anticholinergic, selective M1 receptor blocker. Non-selective MN blockers are propanthaline and oxifonium. Selective MN blockers are pirenzepine, telenzepine. The main side effect with the anticholinergic drug is dry mouth, blurred vision, constipation, and urinary retention. Fourth one is the gastrin antagonist, which is nothing but the proglucamide. But this drug is withdrawn from the market because of its severe hepatotoxicity. The fifth class is prostaglandin analogs. The prostaglandins like PGE1, prostaglandin E2, and prostaglandin I2 act as an anti-ulcer. The drugs which are used to treat the peptic ulcer are prostaglandin analogs are misoprostol, inprostil, rioprostil. Misoprostol is prostaglandin E1 analog. Inprostil and rioprostil are prostaglandin E2 analogs. The role of mucus is to protect the wall of GIT from acid. These drugs are also called cytoprotective agent which protect the cells by enhancing mucus. These drugs are mainly used to treat the ulcer induced by non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs. Okay, and the side effect of this drug means this drug increase gastric motility. Because of that, this drug having diarrhea as a side effect. Anti-Helicobacter pylori drugs. Helicobacter pylori is a gram-negative bacteria. ग्राम नेगेटिव बैक्टीरिया आर मोर हार्मफुल देन द ग्राम पॉजिटिव बैक्टीरिया. एच पायलोरी इन्फेक्शन कैन बी डिटेक्टेड बाय यूरिया ब्रेथ टेस्ट. द ड्रग्स कम्स अंडर दिस कैटेगरीज आर एमोक्सिसिलिन, क्लैरिथ्रोमाइसिन, मेट्रोनिडाजोल, टिनिडाजोल. ओके, द सेकेंड मेन क्लास ऑफ ड्रग विच आर यूज टू ट्रीट द पेप्टिक अल्सर आर एंटासिड्स. एंटासिड्स आर बेसिक और अल्कलाइन सब्सटेंसेस. बिकॉज ऑफ देयर अल्कलाइनिटी दे न्यूट्रलाइज द गैस्ट्रिक एसिड. द मेजर रोल ऑफ एंटासिड इज इन द पेप्टिक अल्सर इज टू प्रोवाइड द प्रॉम्प्ट रिलीफ फ्रॉम द अल्सर पेन. द एंटासिड यूज आर ऑफ टू टाइप, सिस्टमिक एंटासिड एंड नॉन सिस्टमिक एंटासिड. सिस्टमिक एंटासिड्स आर absorbed in the systemic circulation. Because of that they cause a systemic alkalosis and they are less preferred. The example of systemic antacids are sodium bicarbonate and sodium citrate. On the other hand side, non-systemic antacids are not absorbed in the systemic circulation. They don't have any side effect like systemic alkalosis, and because of that they are more preferred. The example of non-systemic antacids are aluminium hydroxide, magnesium hydroxide, magnesium trisilicate. Aluminium hydroxide has a constipation as a side effect. Magnesium hydroxide has a diarrhea as a side effect. To avoid the above side effect, that is the constipation and diarrhea, combination of aluminium hydroxide gel and magnesium hydroxide is used, which is known as megaldrate, which is hydrated complex of magnesium and aluminium hydroxide. The potency of antacid is expressed in terms of ANC, which is nothing but the acid neutralizing capacity. High the value of acid neutralizing capacity, the more potent antacid, the potency of the antacid is more. Okay. Acidic environment is essential for the absorption of iron. Long-term administration of antacid decreases the absorption of iron by providing the basic environment and that result in the iron deficiency anemia. The next class of drug is ulcer protective drugs. Sucralfate, salt of sulfated sucrose, colloidal bismuth substrate. Sucralfate at a pH less than 4 form a sticky gel. This gel is adhered to ulcer and protect it. Because of the solubility in water, sucrose it's not used directly. Antacid decrease or antagonize the activity of sucralfate because sucralfate act only in the acidic medium. Ulcer healing drugs. Carbenoxolone sodium. This drug is obtained from the natural source Glycyrrhiza glabra, also called as liquorice. It contains the saponin glycoside. It having a wound healing property. Side effect of carbenoxolone sodium is hyperaldosteronemia. Okay, here we completed the peptic ulcer. For the peptic ulcer, the main point that you have to remember, first one is the what is meant by the aggressive factor, what is meant by the defensive factor, and what kind of imbalance cause peptic ulcer. What are the what is the general mechanism of acid secretion? How the drug counter that mechanism to treat the peptic ulcer? And what are the different classes of drugs which are used to treat the peptic ulcer? First one is the drug which reduce gastric acid secretion. Second one are the antacids. Third one is the ulcer protective drugs. And last one is the ulcer healing drugs. Okay. Thank you.